various groups and opposition figures commemorate the 38th anniversary of the civilian-backed military revolt that ousted Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. They warn that the legacy of the historic event could be erased by ongoing efforts to amend the country's constitution. Vivian Gulia has tonight's top story.
Hi, I'm EDSA.
With linked arms and clad in yellow, opposition leaders and personalities gathered at the EDSA Shrine Friday morning to attend a mass and participate in a rally, which are part of the activities to mark the 1986 People Power Revolution. Among them are Senator Risa Ontiveros, Albay First District Representative Edsel Lagman, former Senators Leila De Lima and Bam Aquino, and Attorney Chel Diokno. They also issued a call against the ongoing initiatives to amend the 1987 Constitution. Joining them were members of Buhayang EDSA Campaign Network, a coalition of people's organizations, academics, political parties, sectoral formations, and non-government organizations. Many of the participants wore yellow ribbons and carried yellow flowers. For the coalition, coming together in defense of freedoms, which Filipinos fought for 38 years ago, keeps the spirit of EDSA alive. Commemorating the 1986 People Power Revolution aims to remind those in authority that people will not stay silent against those who seek to perpetuate themselves in power.
Hindi pwede na wala na yung ang diwan ng EDSA. Nandyan pa ho at palalakasin ho natin lagi yan sa pananawagan natin ng katinuan sa pamahalaan, kaayusan sa pamahalaan.
We can never underestimate the value of prayer. God should always be in the equation whenever we fight for justice, human rights, protection of the poor.
Apart from concerns that amending the charter could weaken the constitutionally guaranteed safeguards to people's rights, Ontiveros and Diokno believe the initiative could also be part of efforts to erase the legacy of the 1986 EDSA People Power, which toppled the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
All of those come together, yung pagtanggal sa pamana ng EDSA, yung pagtanggal sa anibersaryo ng People Power Revolution bilang opisyal na holiday. And yes, itong chacha dahil ang 1987 Constitution ay bunga ng EDSA People Power Revolution.
Marami na rin mga galaw sa edukasyon para sabihin nila na golden age nga yung time na yun. Samantalang alam naman natin na hindi. At itong pagbabago ng konstitusyon, parang gusto na rin nilang makalimutan yung nangyari at kung bakit tayo nagtayo ng 1987 Constitution.
The President and the leaders of both houses of Congress gave assurances they are only interested in amending the restrictive economic provisions of the Charter to attract more foreign investments into the country. But several groups have expressed doubts, including workers, farmers, women and teachers who participated in rallies in Metro Manila on Friday. They will again stage a rally on February 25th to commemorate the EDSA anniversary and protest against Chacha. The Tindig mascot, inspired by a raised fist, will be part of the gathering.
Very fitting na gamitin yung tumindig kasi diba yung symbol ng fist, ginagamit siya ng mga activist para patampokin yung mga iba't ibang issues. Pero may kinalaman in general sa kalagayan ng mga Pilipino. Mostly human rights yung pinaglalaban.
The Philippine National Police plans to deploy around 8,000 cops to activities in Metro Manila and Cebu on February 25th. It has yet to monitor security threats.
Yung pagpo-provide po natin ng security is not only for those who will be affected but also doon sa grupo po nila na sila rin po ay ma-secure. Mamaya may mga makapasok po doon na may mga manggugulo for whatever interest na gusto nilang i-propagate.
PNP Chief General Benjamin Acorda Jr. had said that police will implement maximum tolerance but also appealed to protesters to hold their activities in a peaceful and orderly manner. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.